When I heard that the Google Photos free unlimited storage was going away this year, I kind of panicked a little bit, and then I sort of forgot about it. And now it's kicking in on June 1st, which as of the time of recording this video, is about 1 week from today, which means I had to go into overdrive mode and figure out, what am I gonna do? Because, you know, as soon as we had kids, we started taking lots of pictures. Anybody with kids might know how that is. And so that Google Photos gets used quite a bit. So what are the options? If you want the short version of this video, I'm gonna explain a few of the cloud storage backup alternatives to this and which one I chose, as well as outlining what the other options are in case those would make more sense for you. The really short version here is, I'm gonna go with the Amazon Prime thing because one thing that I didn't realize until I researched it, maybe you didn't know, is if you're already paying for Amazon Prime, you are already paying for unlimited photo backup. So that's the one I went with. Now there are some caveats there that doesn't include unlimited video, unlike the free Google Photos thing that that we're losing access to. So let's back up a little bit and talk about the various options and what's going on here. So basically, Google Photos used to allow you to unlimited backup all of your photos and all of your videos. That's stopping. Here's what Google would like you to do. They would like you to buy access to their Google One subscription. And the main advantage to this is you can keep doing exactly what you've been doing. You can keep using Google Photos and things won't really change other than that you're now paying money for something that you used to get for free. So if you do want to pay for it, what exactly are you going to be paying? What are the options and what does it get you? Let's take a quick look at that. Okay, so you stick with Google. That means you're subscribing to Google One, which is going to give you some cloud storage. You can get 100 gigabytes for $1.99 per month, or you could pay $19.99 per year to get a discount if you bundle it all at once. You could also step up to the 200 gigabyte plan for $2.99 a month, or the $29.99 per year if you get the year discount on that one. You can also get 2 terabytes for $9.99 a month, or you could pay $99.99 for the full year on the 2 terabyte plan. Now, the advantage here is that this is gonna be the easiest thing to do if you already want, you're already using Google Photos and you wanna just keep doing that. Again, the disadvantage is the price. You also should find out how much space you're actually using on Google Photos, and maybe even trying to figure out, like, on a monthly basis, yearly basis, how much have you been adding to that? Because if you continue your practice of just backing up everything to Google Photos, how fast are you gonna burn through the, like, 100 gigabyte, 200 gigabyte? Are you gonna need the terabyte, 2 terabyte? You know, and you also aren't sure when Google's pricing might increase on all of these things. It really is something to think about. All right, let's jump over now to what I'm gonna do, which is the Amazon Prime subscription. So first of all, if you're already paying for Amazon Prime, this is going to be the equivalent of free for you, other than it'll be, I guess, harder to eventually unsubscribe from Amazon Prime if that was something that you would maybe have considered doing in the future. But if you're already paying this fee, then this is no additional cost. The main downside is that it does not give you unlimited video. It does give you unlimited full resolution photos though. The video, I believe, for included in your Prime subscription is limited to 5 gigabytes, which if you upload a lot of videos will get used up extremely quickly. But if you are gonna use that up, you can subscribe to additional cloud storage from Amazon. Let's jump into the pricing tiers on that. So the Amazon pricing tiers are 100 gigabytes for $1.99 per month, or $19.99 per year. You can get 1 terabyte for $6.99 per month, or $59.99 per year. And you can get 2 terabytes for $11.99 a month, or $119.98 per year. But something to really think about when you're comparing these pricing plans to the Google pricing plans. If you're already paying for Amazon Prime, again, that's the caveat, then you're already backing up all the photos for free. So all of that extra space that you're getting there could be dedicated to video backup. Unlike if you're doing the Google Photos one. If you're doing Google One, then that's gonna be a shared data between all of your Google stuff, Google Drive, everything, your photos, your videos, all of it is sharing that. Whereas the Amazon one is on top of your unlimited photos, meaning that, again, it can just be using on the video. So you could probably get away with a lower subscription amount, and maybe you don't even care about video, in which case the just Prime itself is gonna cover what you need. Okay, let's talk about some other options. Now, one option that I didn't consider a whole lot is going with Apple, because I'm an Android phone user, so it doesn't make sense for me to consider this. But you, watching this video, might be an iPhone user, in which case iCloud might make the most sense for you, especially if you're not already subscribed to Amazon Prime. So, iCloud subscriptions. You can get a 50 gigabyte plan for 99 cents a month, you can get a 200 gigabyte plan for $2.99 a month, and you can get a 2 terabyte plan for $9.99 a month, and Apple doesn't seem to offer any kind of buy a year and get a discount options. And, you know, if you're big into the Apple ecosystem, this could be a nice way to go for you for integration into all of that. Like I said, not for me personally, but that's fine. Now, the last one that I seriously considered was Microsoft 365 as a cloud storage option. Let's jump into what that gets you. The pricing tiers here are a little bit different than how the other ones were doing it. So the Microsoft 365 / OneDrive kind of thing can give you a 1 terabyte plan, and that's it. You get a 1 terabyte plan. But the differences are you can either buy a personal one or you can buy a family account. And there's where your pricing differences come in. The personal plan is $6.99 per month, or you can buy a year at a time for $69.99. And you could then consider the alternative of getting a family plan, which would be $9.99 a month or $99.99 per year if you get the yearly discount. Now, the advantage here is with the family plan, I think you're each getting 1 terabyte. So if you have multiple people in your home using this cloud storage, then that could start to add up to a pretty good deal. If you want to go that route. Okay, so those are the main options to consider. Like I said, I think if you're an Amazon Prime subscriber, you should seriously consider going the Amazon route, especially if you're not that into uploading video. If it's mainly for photos, Amazon seems to be the way to go. You're not going to pay any more than you're already paying for your Amazon Prime subscription, so you won't notice it in your monthly budget, and you're going to get free unlimited photo backup. Now let's talk about a few other little details and wrinkles in this situation for Google Pixel users. In other words, if you have a Pixel phone. Now, backdated to older Pixel phones, which were purchased on the understanding that they would get permanent unlimited uploading to Google Photos, Google is not taking that deal away from those older phones that are grandfather clauses in. So if you have one of those older phones, you can keep doing it, but the unlimited storage is only going to count on things uploaded from that device. So if you're uploading from your PC or somebody else's phone, a different phone that you have, it's not going to count. Now, this does bring me to a possible workaround on this whole situation, which is, what if you buy an old used Google Pixel phone that's grandfather clauses in, and then maybe try to, like, you know, unlimited upload from there? I don't know if Google checks that, you know, you didn't buy that phone when that deal was available or something like that. I haven't checked into the details on this. It's not something I'm going to try personally, but might be an interesting route to investigate, as kind of like put everything you want on Google Photos onto an old Google Pixel phone to actually do the upload. Seems like a bit of a hassle, not worth it to me, but something that you could consider. All right, guys, hopefully this was helpful for you, and I hope that you guys have an excellent day.